Summer sunshine.
We are LA.
Having fun. Summer sunshine. Change your mind.
Ain't so far away.
Where am I going with this?
Welcome to another installment of KIDD Radio. Radio with a View. KIDD. I'm in the studio here with my bros, my co-hosts are Eric Von Drummer and the man in the back.
Yeah,
and we got Arthur Dominguez.
Hello there.
Bass player extraordinaire.
Attaboy.
We got Tony over here, drummer extraordinaire from our
T1 name. From 3DC.
There you go.
All right.
In Calejo, where would you say you're? How would you say where you're from?
I come from where I'm at, where I was.
Okay.
Hey, how long ago was that?
Okay. Oh, I think that's a little bit of Rod Serling, or maybe Twilight Zone stuff. So.
Parts unknown.
I'll fill you in. He's a Zeppelin fan. He plays Les Paul. He's also a friend of ours that jams in here in our studio next door. But we're gonna bring you some stuff. We're gonna show you some stuff. We're gonna bring you some stuff from 5 Mile Radius, another local band around here, and just showcase them for a minute, and talk about some other stuff. We get this the 4th of July. They're playing the Wilson Park. A lot of people know where Wilson Park is. That's a pretty big event. And 5 Mile Radius is a good band and perfect for that event. But we will be playing ourselves as well at a private party. Call or comment for details, or you can Twitter or whatever the hell you do. We're going to do a couple cover songs for fun. We like to do that, a few of our favorite bands. And it spices up the party a little bit. I'm about to kick these guys on out. I swear to God. That's funny. We like to have fun. We like to have fun here at KIDD Radio, and it's all done with love.
I love you, man.
Love you, too.
Love you, too.
But come a little closer. Let my boot. I can't hear you.
Oh, come a little closer. I can't hear my boot hitting your head.
All right, but we're gonna bring in some 5 Mile Radius and some other stuff. And we appreciate all you listeners that did listen in last time. And we plan on spicing things up. Let's talk about the beginning of the show. A song called Southside Groovin'. Just one day we were just like trying to record, and it was just it was mayhem going on. So we just kind of let the tape roll and just recorded whatever, right? And so it's just a bunch of like different like Frankenstein stuff thrown together, you know? Just didn't care who was walking in. You'll hear all kinds of stuff in the background. And I'm singing out of tune on purpose because it's funny. I think it's funny.
Yeah.
Big LA.
But it's very tasty song too.
But and also you might have to have some psychedelics when you watch that stuff because that's the way it should be watched.
Most definitely. But, with a sense of humor.
Yeah, and then when you hear my voice, you go, "That's horrible for sure." But that's supposed to be on purpose. Also, some things on KIDD Radio to let you know. We're gonna have we got a friend. He's just I don't know a few days old. And he's a comedian. He's a baby comedian.
Like a baby Huey.
Pretty smart kid, man. You'll trip on this guy. Pretty funny kid. Okay, so you're gonna hear some of that stuff up. Besides the man in the back and some of Eric's and Arthur's interviews with different artists, stuff like that. You're gonna have some comedy, and we're gonna surprise you with a lot of footage of different stuff. And some big artists and stars as well will be coming up on the show pretty soon. We do thank you for tuning into the show. We hope to keep you guys happy. Everybody just kind of chirp in and comment in. We're going to have the chat lines open and stuff like that. And we'll be going completely live soon. But right now we're just having fun with it and trying things out and testing the water. All right. So without further ado, let me introduce you to some friends of mine. And they're called 5 Mile Radius.
Cool and stuff. It might just be.
Thanks, man.
What's up, man?
Can't tell you.
Hey. What's happening?
All right.
Coming to you live from a 5 mile radius rehearsal room, and we got you know what, I'm gonna have them introduce themselves right here for us, and starting with Bill, my buddy Bill right here on the left.
My name is Bill Walski. I'm the lead singer, percussionist, and harmonica player.
Doug Haynes on drums.
Mike, I play bass.
I'm Kenny, I'm the janitor.
Brian Yisha, our guitar player, he's not here tonight, he had to call it a night, but Brian plays the keys and does a lot of singing backup and is a lead guitar player too. And don't let Kenny fool you, when he's not mopping our floors, he's also playing the guitar.
You guys, a couple of you went to Carson High School or went to Carson?
I did. Right. Okay. Yep. Same time you guys were across the street, intimidating all the kids in school.
Well, I mean, those were the days, weren't they?
But, no, those were the days, man. Yeah. It was good stuff.
Mike, what high school did you go to? Did they have high school back?
No.
Yeah.
I was outside the Longdale High School. That's almost like Beverly Hills back then.
Yeah. You were still in the Bronx when you graduated.
That's right. I was still knifing people.
Doug is from the Bronx, New York, and I grew up in Cleveland, Ohio. Where'd Brian graduate from?
He didn't.
Did he
graduate from high school with you? You guys go to the same school?
I think he went to Narbonne.
Narbonne?
Yeah.
Brian's from Chicago, I know that, but I guess he was out here by the time he graduated high school.
So we got half of a local California bunch right here, but that's cool that you got a couple other guys from
A couple of homegrown boys and a couple of transplants.
That's cool, because I got relatives near Cleveland, Akron, and
That's where I went to college, yeah. Really? I lived in Cuyahoga Falls before I moved here.
Really? Wow, that's where all my relatives, a lot of my relatives are in Ohio. And they'll be glad to hear that we're talking about them right now instead of you.
The
Buckeyes, there you go. And hey, there was another place called Shooters down right on the river.
I remember Shooters, been there many times.
Yeah, we played there, and then it burnt down right after we played there.
Oh, really?
That's what I heard, it burnt down.
Yeah,
right when you guys walked out.
Bill, what do you know about that, Bill?
Coincidence?
Yeah, what do you know about that?
How long have you guys been together now? And
Well, the biggest piece of history is between Kenny and Brian. You guys have been playing together since you were
junior high.
All right.
Yeah.
Junior high school, man.
It's like 3 years now.
And then we picked Mike up shortly afterwards. God, man, this has been a long time, dude.
Yeah, like 30,000 years or something. Wow. It's like the Pleistocene era. What they call it?
I think
Paleozoic.
Paleozoic.
They used to play for mastodons.
Yeah.
Saber-toothed tigers.
The Flintstones.
Wearing animal skins.
I joined the band purely by accident. Brian is a coworker of my best friend, and they were playing in Torrance about two blocks away from my house. And Dave tells me, he says, "Hey man, I'm gonna go down and see my coworker Brian's band." And I went down there and he introduced me to the guys, and he said, "Oh yeah, this is my buddy Bill. You know, he plays harmonica." And so Kenny and Brian actually said, "Well, you know, maybe we can get together at an open mic night and, you know, hear you play a little bit of your music and we'll play a little bit of music with you." And so it was Serendipity that I joined, and that was a little over a year ago. You know, they said, "Hey,
this is us."
What? Serendipity?
Who the f*** is that?
I'll write it out for you so you can see.
Serendipity.
this is a Carson High School education. You'll
learn. You'll have to do it.
And Doug, we picked you up in what, September of 2009?
Yeah.
September of 2009.
Good month.
Rehearsed.
Yeah. And what you don't know,
no more drummers.
What you don't know is that the Doug is actually our drummer emeritus. He had to leave us. He got transferred over to Dallas for his job. And
camera in front of him, and that's what happened.
Hey man, I'm a personality. What can I tell you? This is why I'm the front man. I do all the talking.
Beautiful.
But we have another drummer by the name of Mike Pochapan. We call him Poch, and then Dougie here is our drummer emeritus, and he's back from Dallas for this very special gig that we've got coming up on the 4th of July.
Cool.
Nice. Where are you guys playing?
We're playing at Wilson Park.
That's
big,
a good one.
Big
yeah.
Park in Torrance.
That's a good show.
Good park. Yeah.
That is going to be jam-packed.
What, 400,000 or 500,000 people are going to be there?
Something like that.
It's going to be like
you're looking at half
the million. Whole world.
It's bigger than Woodstock.
It's like a Woodstock right here in Torrance.
50.
Yeah. That's a good gig. That's going to be a great gig.
I've heard estimates anywhere between 10 and 20,000 people are going to be there.
Oh, there'll be more. There'll be more than that, man.
Helicopters and everything.
Yeah, they're going to fly us in.
Put it this way. That's where I used to go.
What kind of music do you guys play, anyhow? It's by Mount Radius, but what is it?
Classic rock.
Blues.
Yeah, classic rock.
What are some of the songs?
Whatever strikes our mood at
the moment. Well, you know, we have a constantly evolving set list, as you can see here on the dry erase board. You know, we've constantly got, you know, songs that we want to play, songs that we've kind of run through a couple of times, songs that are in our stable. We got about 60, 65, maybe 70 songs in our regular rotation. Everything from the Black Crows to... Led Zeppelin, the Rolling Stones, you know, a little bit of Joe Cocker, a lot of old blues songs. You know, when I joined the band, brought my harps with me, I was able to sweet talk to the rest of the guys and embracing a little bit more of that dirty Chicago sound.
Nice.
And you know, a lot of American classic rock, Southern rock, and you know, British invasion stuff too.
I got one question. Who put Seek and Destroy? It's got to be a drummer.
That's these guys from way back.
That's a great Metallica song. Yeah, Living After Midnight, you got the Priest up there. Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you what, man, this guy here is a walking library of Black Sabbath songs.
That's great.
You name a song and he will play it, and he will play it just like the record. Yeah.
I'm looking for a band to play some of that shit.
We're not called 5 Mile Radius for nothing. We like to stay local. We all live and work in the South Bay, and that's where we like to play out too. So we've played at CJ's Sports Bar in Torrance. We've played at the Firehouse in Lomita. We've played at Keegan's in Torrance. We played at Kilkenny's over on the pier.
Was that Gallery?
What was that other place? Oh yeah, well we did a fundraiser for a theater in San Pedro at an art gallery.
That turned out good.
That was
nice.
Yeah, that was great.
We'll travel anywhere for money.
Oh, we played the Crest. We played the Crest at Old Torrance, right around the corner from
me. Yeah, everybody knows where the Crest is.
And we're real fucking cheap, man.
Yeah, let me tell you something. These guys simply rock. If you like classic rock music, these are the guys to come watch. And if you're in the South Bay area of California, this truly is the band to come see.
No joke. We're on the 4th of July.
Come on down to 4th of July, Wilson Park. You know, a lot of people I know will be there.
Hey, there's fireworks after the concert, too. Imagine that.
That's right.
This will be out before the 4th of July, so this is a good plug for you guys.
Hey, what day is it today? Is it Sunday? What are you doing watching this? Get over to Wilson Park right now.
There you go. Right on, man.
It's free.
All right, well, I'd like to thank you guys, you know, and it's always a pleasure to see you guys and watch you guys play.
You guys do rock. We love hearing you guys.
Absolutely, man. The feeling is mutual.
Cool.
I like your show, man. It's good, but I'll tell you what. While you're doing that show, you guys aren't in there rocking, and that's really where you belong, man.
That's true. Well, I do that when my band's not here. So,
put our friends with us, man.
Nice.
Yeah. I'm there a lot.
When you go to our site, you're gonna see this.
You guys are awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, thanks, man. So are you guys. We really.
Goodbye, Radio Land. Goodbye, Internet Land.
Right on.
Kicking with Kowboy.
There it is. Kicking with Kowboy. All right. 5 Mile Radius, ladies and gentlemen.
You're listening to KIDD Radio, Radio with a View.
Yeah. Woo. All right. Yeah. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
This is the man in the back, kicking it with Kowboy on KIDD Radio, Radio with a View.
Alright.
That's not funny.
That shit's funny.
Hey,
I got a fart.
Where you guys been there for your joint? Not here, right?
Who's playing? Yeah, we're playing in the 4th of July. People that listen to the show that want to go, check it out. Everybody's welcome. But we're not going to tell you over the radio where it's at. You're going to have to comment, message us, call us, something.
Smoke signals, whatever they can get.
Smoke signals will work.
We have a very special guest band, too. Dr. Bellows and the Medicine Jar.
Yeah, some people might remember them guys. doctor and people.
Go take tips too.
Yeah, the doctor is in
the house.
The doctor.
Not
doctor
MGA
in Detroit.
MGB, yeah.
Sure, I'll take one of them cigarettes.
Sure.
Thank you, very nice.
That's medical.
So, as you can tell, we're all been drinking.
Come on.
We rehearsed.
Thanks to Calejo.
Our studio is right here where we rehearse, and it's the same as the radio station. You hear the cars going by? That is, that right there, that's me tapping on Steve's forehead.
Thank God!
Why are you yelling, man?
I'm sorry.
Why are you yelling at me?
Don't be yelling at me.
Don't yell at me.
What
did I do?
What
happened to all the love? See what happens when you get people drunk? You get them just a little alcohol. All of a sudden, boom, Google eyes.
What's the man in the back doing?
I don't know, but he's about to get fired. You're fired.
Fired.
Hey. No. We're officially hiring a new mascot.
Yeah, so if anybody knows anybody that's mentally handicapped,
or anybody,
you're welcome to suggest them.
Are from the Mucus production from Eric Von Drummer's side.
We cannot find
Know what he just said.
We cannot find another one if we try.
There's only one man in the back. There's only
it
one man
the
in
mold.
The back. No, yeah, but honestly, that's ridiculous. And if you want to sit down,
Did somebody spit at me?
Did somebody feed him some chocolate?
Somebody give him some sugar. Tony, I want to know who are your five best drummers that you like? Top five drummers.
I can't do that, man. You mean you're good. Five drummers. Neil Burt, John Bonham.
That's two.
Yeah.
Come on, you had three more.
I can't think of any of them.
Neil Burt, John Bonham.
That's cool.
And Eric
Von
Drummer right there. There you go.
There he goes. He's
fast. Five drummers coming up.
I'm going to be at a party with the California Cowboys.
The baby?
Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about this baby. We ran into this little baby, and I don't know. Usually would say, how did you run into a baby? The baby walked up in the room over here, and we said, and he's just like, can't be more than a few days old. And he can talk and everything, and not only can he talk, but he's got the mouth of a sailor, and I think he's an alcoholic at a young age. He claims that his mom was on crack and everything else when he was in her stomach or something, and that's where he learned all his stuff, was from her and her friends being in her belly. If you can believe that, that's funny stuff. But anyway, we want to bring the baby in here and let you decide. What should we do with this? Because you'd normally think, well, you should find his parents. Well, if you hear his story, I'm not so sure you would say bring him back to his mother. Okay? Because, you know.
But he got dropped off of a snort, a you know, stork or something.
He said she tried to put him in a dumpster or something, and he ended up doing that to her. He's a baby. It's hilarious. Anyway. We got another Eric in the room over here. Eric, you want to say, hey, what up?
Hey, what's up?
That's what he says. Eric's another drummer. He's our second stringer, I guess you could say. You know,
he's in the posse.
Yeah,
he's on the team.
He's on the team.
He's a baby drummer, Eric.
But the baby is kind of hard to take. I don't know exactly how you're gonna take it. At first, I was a little bit offended, or not offended. Like, let's just say I was like amazed and going, "Wow, what is all this?" And then once you get to talking to him for a minute. It is funny stuff, you know, and it's like, okay, he's like a baby a few days old, 21 days old or something, right? But he claims he's 21 the way he talks and carries himself. But I'm not doubting him because it's funny because he's like an adult baby.
Well, I'll tell you something.
Comedian. He said, what?
If it's a little guy, I'd be changing his ass with a diaper or something.
Well, it's, people still got to change his diapers, I guess. It ain't going to be me.
But this baby was running out to the middle of the road saying, fuck you.
They got him in the green room.
F you.
They got him in the green room, and Steve's just stepping on Fatty. I wonder where Fatty's at.
Under my feet.
The baby's in the green room, apparently, with green baby shit all over the place.
That's tearing it up in there.
I guess he's buzzed.
That's first poo-poo.
We did not get the baby drunk. We do not. Promote getting anybody under 21 years of age alcohol or anything of that nature, but this one came intoxicated into the room, and we said, hold up a second, somebody clean up the baby and then bring him back in here, and we're going to let him do his thing. He claims he's a comedian, and he's seen us doing a show, and he says, I want on the show. So we said, okay, this is for the listeners to decide, okay? So coming up right now, we're going to have the baby right after this message, okay? But for now, we got a message. We must pause for station identification and a sponsorship. As a matter of fact, we are looking for sponsorship. Right now, we only have one sponsor. We have one sponsor and one sponsor.
That's right.
And the other one has baby shit on his ass.
All right. But we're going to run our one sponsor's ad. And then we'll be right back with the baby. You're listening to KIDD Radio, Radio with a View.
Cowboy for governor. He's badass. He cares.
This is the man in the back, kicking it with Cowboy on KIDD Radio, Radio with a View. Bring it home to Papa.
You guys want to hear something funny? You want to hear something funny? Your mama. Yeah, what's up with that, man? Let me tell you, well, I'm a baby, all right? I'm funny because I learned all kinds of stuff and I was in my crack mama's womb. So anyway, I'm at the hospital getting born, right? And then the doctor trips me upside down and he's about to smack me. I said, hey, doc, what the f*** you doing? You know what the f***? Make yourself useful and get me a f***ing mixed drink and a smoke. Man, so I look at the nurse. The nurse says, what a cute baby. I said, yeah, baby, you want to mow the yard? So she gives me her number, right? I'm kicking back at her pad. Everybody's going, what happened to the baby? You know, because they thought I would be in there with all them other screaming, spoiled brats yelling and slobbering shit and herself everywhere. But luckily, there was a liquor store next door, and it was these two bums. I said, hey, can you spot me a 40? And they said, you're a baby. I said, I know what the f*** I am, and you're a bum. So get me a beer, asshole, I'm buying. Have you ever seen my crack mama? She's all f***ed up on shit. Everything she got, I'm addicted to it too, all right? So I got to get myself a rock real quick. Look at her. Look at her. I got hang-ups. Whatever she's on, I'm on it too. And so the second time she stuck me in a dumpster, I think it was in South Central or some shit. I scored some mushrooms like the second day I was on the planet. Man. I look like you are the turnip truck. Who is this guy anyway? You guys call him the man in the back? The man would have had too much sack. Shit, why don't you give me some of that? I'll go make some money. Shit. Look, nobody ever thinks a baby. They're gonna, you know, what am I gonna call the cops? Fuck, I'm a baby, I don't even know the number. I know this, man, you got a 20, I got a dub. Shit. Yeah, well, I'm gonna have some teeth some damn day. And when I do, I'm gonna keep them motherfuckers too. Yeah, well, I don't play on nobody's team. See, I travel alone. I'm the lone baby, maverick. I don't take nobody's shit, man. I call the shots, I'm a shot caller. Got me a cab. I didn't even pay the cab driver. I said, I'm a baby, what do you think, I got money? He says, I'm surprised you're talking. I said, I'm surprised you're driving that car, you f***ing towel head. F***ing a diaper on his head, I got mine on my ass, what the f***? Yeah, no, that's where you were licking my crack. I don't ride on f***ing bicycles, man. I'm a baby. I need a tricycle or some shit. Whenever it's time, I mean, because I don't know how to ride a tricycle yet either. See these feet? I pretend I don't know how to use them. And I don't mess around with other ladies. Hey, baby, what's up? No, I don't do that shit. I say, hey, mama, what you doing? She's a MILF. No, y'all even do me a GILF. Shit. I'll do a MILF, a GILF, I'll do anything but a baby. Yes, I'm a baby, why am I wearing a baby? I said my name is Joe Brown, ask me again and knock you down. Yeah, my name is Puddin' Tang, ask me again and tell you the same. Shit. Somebody want to get this guy to the doctor? The head doctor? He needs a shrink. Look at the size of that melon. What is that, for driving movie theaters or something? Got a projector. Shit. I don't just show cartoons and that shit. If I show cartoons, it's sick and twisted.
And he even sent the man in the back to watch you. That's why he's here.
I know, and this guy, he's the one who needs a babysitter. You scared me. Nah, that's good. I think they dropped you in your head instead. Shit. Well, shut up and get me a cocktail. I was drinking some red wine. Shit, I don't know. It was cheap. Fucking, it wasn't no Cabernet Sauvignon. It was like box of wine or something. Because I'm a baby. I can't afford expensive shit, you know? I only can take what I can steal. They never think it's me, though, because I'm a baby. When I'm done with the wine, I climb up inside that box. Nobody knows where I'm at and shit. That's one time I almost got tossed in the trash can, and the trash guy came and shit. I said, hey, what are you doing? Fool, let me out of here. He said, hey, yo, check this out, Charlie, this box is talking. I said, it's not a box, you asshole, I'm a baby. I'm in the trash can, see what the mom does to me? Where am I going to be on the 4th of July? Drunk? I'm going to be at a party with the California Cowboys. I'm out of here, man. I got to get out. I'm out of that window. Hey, open that window. Open up the window and let me catch my breath, sucker.
Hey, he wants you to do the commercial, KIDD. Come on.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's the whole, he said I could do my comedy shtick for you losers if I said some bullshit like KIDD radio. Radio with a view. I'll be in town all week. KIDD radio. Radio with a view. And I'm a baby with a view. Radio with a pew. That's my diaper. I'm gonna mow the yard with these two chicks. You listen to KIDD radio. Hey, Cowboy, leave my chicks alone.
The views and opinions expressed by the baby do not necessarily express the views or opinions of us here at KIDD Radio. However, there is a growing problem and issue where people are leaving babies in dumpsters and on people's doorsteps and what have you. And I happen to know of a personal story where the fire department was deployed to an apartment complex where there was a dumpster on fire. Well, by the time the fire department got the fire out and everything, they had discovered it was another case of somebody that had a baby and didn't want it, and they put it in a dumpster and they set the dumpster afire to cover up for their crime. Well, in fact, this is a crime. This is murder, and I'm not good with this. I'm not at all good with murderers. Okay? There is plenty of places you can drop the baby off at a fire department, no questions asked. And these are living people. Okay? This is horrible. And this is kind of why this story is, you know, we make jokes of it and stuff, but this is the truth. This is really happening here in America and around the world. And we have to be good humans, people. Come on. Now, come on. But do not do this. This is murder. This is murder in the first degree, and I don't like it. And I'm not going to stand for it. I got a big mouth, and I got an opinion. I got a lot of love, but I tell you what, I do not tolerate murder. Now, here's a statement that does reflect the opinions and views of us here at KIDD Radio. Love is my weapon, and I don't lose, okay? I may go away soon, I may not, but you're going to remember this. Love is my weapon, and I never will lose. I will live forever. 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 Now, on another note, everybody obviously knows I've been working hard for the last, you know, 3 or 4 years, putting together the Regulators band back together. They have decided to get back together, and it makes me very happy. And my blessings go with them, but I, as you know, have a solo career, and I feel bad about that, because I have a lot of love for that. You obviously know that, but this is just something I need to do, because I gotta try it. I gotta try it this way, okay? And you know, nobody's saying, this is gonna work or this ain't gonna work. Nobody knows exactly what, when, and why, okay? You think you might, you don't, okay? Nobody really knows what's going to happen next, okay? But I tell you this, my blessings do go out to my brothers and the regulators, and I'm very proud of them, very proud of them, okay? And I want them to do very good. And you know, I even told him, if we could possibly get the bands together, tour, I would be in both of them, you know, because I love for the regulars, you know, of course you know that. And there's a lot of history in that. But I do feel that there's somewhat of a curse that comes with it. Maybe a lot of drama, maybe a lot of people expecting me to live my life their way. And I can't do that anymore, okay? Because that's where I find my failure, okay? And I must be me. And that's, you know, just the way I feel. It doesn't mean I'm going to succeed or it's going to be great. Nobody knows. But I'm just doing what I want to do. I'm just taking it day by day and I'm just trying to love life, okay? I'm trying to love you. You know, people, it's love. It's love that brings it all together. And there's nothing about love if we don't show it to each other. We can't be hating on each other. And we certainly can't be putting babies in dumpsters and catching them on fire, okay? It's sad. Okay, we have to be responsible humans. We have to be good humans. Go out and be a good human, okay? Let's make a difference, one person at a time. We can do it. Now, on another note, a couple plugs. I got a lot of friends in Europe and Italy. Alessio Mazza, Alex Sledge, you my dog, man, okay? And I want people to know who you are because you're good people, man. And you're a great musician, and you got a big heart. And you're just like my brother from another mother, okay? You represent me, and I represent you on each side of the globe, okay, brother? And I gotta make a mention, I gotta put out a plug for that as well. I got a moment to do that. And these are the moments at the end of the show that I think we're gonna spend heartfelt truth, just telling it the way it is. You know, you don't have to cry, or you can if you want. It don't matter. This is real radio. Radio with a view, okay? And I just tell it like it is. And remember, love is my weapon, and I will never lose, okay? Now, I'm the man of many monikers. You know, you call me Cowboy, the California Kid, Rip Roarin', Brother Reverend Range, or Randy. But I would like you to remember me as Love. I believe love is maybe another word for God. Now, if you was to replace, every time you used to say God with love, or vice versa, you know what? You'd find a formula in that, a winning, successful formula in that. But too many people do not want to accept love. They don't want to accept God. And I would just like to get through to them and show them that I'm just trying to love them. I'm a disciple. I'm a disciple of love. And I'm a love guru. I'm just trying to be real, okay? And what I'm doing here is I'm trying to get people to unite under one umbrella, the umbrella of love. Because that's where we will win. The answer to every question, to every problem, the solution is love. If only we knew how to use it like a tool. But I tell you this, love somebody instead of trying to hate on them. Say something good about somebody instead of trying to say something bad all the time. I'm not trying to preach at you, I'm just telling you the truth. I just want you to see that because I care. All right? Be thankful for this country because we lost a lot of good people fighting and dying for it, and we sit back and badger it and badmouth it, and nowhere in the world can you do that. This is a great country. If you can sit back and do that to your country, what kind of great country do you got? When can we say thank you? Thank you, my brothers, for dying and for keeping me free. I know that we got our problems here, and there's a lot of, we got economy problems and recession, but let me tell you something right now, we could be a lot worse off than we are right now. You know, and it starts right here. It starts with you. It starts with you, my friend, looking in the mirror and saying, my bad, because it is you that can make a difference. If everybody stood in front of the mirror and said, my bad, now you have been redeemed. You have already been forgiven. It was waiting for you to go and see yourself in the mirror and say, my bad. Now I'm going to do something about it. One day at a time, and maybe one person at a time. I'm not going to try to change the world's mind overnight. As a matter of fact, I don't think it's going to happen. This is my way of saying, I wanted you to know I was watching the show. everybody, be good human beings, all right? And see if you can't make a difference, because when you affect one life, you affect a life, they affect a life. And you can do it positively or negatively. And we like to hear at KIDD Radio to do it with positive love is our weapon. We never lose. So have a good 4th of July and be safe. Yeah. All right? Have fun.
Everybody.
All right.
See you and have a good one.
We're out.
See ya.
You've been listening to KIDD Radio, Radio with a View.